years from now. That little guy will be 2 years older, so he'll be able to stay awake a little later. Now, the competitors are being introduced to the big crowd here at the Kazan Arena. First of all, the competitors from Japan, Abe and Adashi from Turkey, Akun and Jimmy Khan, the Canadians, Leclerc and Provost, Czech Republic. They are represented by Sabuka and Polubova. Here come the French combination. A very familiar face there. Virginie Dedieu and her partner here, the 37-year-old Benoit Coupi from the Ukraine, Resnik and Timofeyev. Another familiar face here representing Spain. She's back. Gemma Mengual. Carl Reeves is her partner here. Mengual at 38. Now the Americans. Bill May with his longtime partner, Christina Lum Underwood. The Italians, Minicini and Perapatu. And the Russians. Aleksandr Maltsev and Darina Valitova, the silver medalists in the mixed duet tech final. Gee, there's some big names in that group.
Certainly are. So much anticipation. It's been talked about non-stop since November in synchronized swimming world. So exciting now to be at these mixed duet free finals.
I mentioned Virginie Dedieu and Gemma Mengual. They have competed against each other on the world stage so often. In fact, if you go back to Melbourne, the championships in 2007, it was Dedieu who took the gold medal in the solo free. Mengual took the bronze, and a lady we saw collecting a gold medal just a short time ago separated them. That was Natalia Ishenko. So Mengual and Dedieu do battle again. Ishenko is still competing here as well.
And it's fantastic to see them back in the pool. I mean, Gemma Mengual, since she's retired, she's had a little boy, she's opened up a restaurant in Barcelona. She has a whole life, still very much with synchronized swimming, doing a lot of coaching. But she just wanted to grab the opportunity of being back here swimming. Virginie Dedieu, it's not been easy. She lives in France, her partner lives in Las Vegas. They've been getting together for sort of 5 or 6 day training camps whenever they possibly can. And in the early days, you'd video a lot as well. So the judging panels will be looking at the execution and then the artistic impression, and then another panel looking at difficulty. So 5 judges on each of those panels. Then they take off the highest and the lowest scores to get the final score. You can see that they sit up quite high on the side of the pool and just judge what they see above the water and through the water. And the difficulty judges intermingled with some of the execution and artistic.
I think I'm right in saying it's a totally new panel of judges than we saw from the previous event.
They do normally change them for each event. Keeps it fresh, keeps them ready. Do you know what's going to be interesting for me on this duet final as we look at the start list there?
Japan, Turkey, Canada, the Czech Republic and France, the first 5 to compete. 10 teams in total in the mixed duet free final here. And then it will be the Ukraine and Spain, the United States, probably favourites for the gold, you'd suggest, then Italy and Russia, a big chance, the Russians going last.
It's going to be interesting to see how the judges really score this, because some duets it will be the man really complimenting the woman, the others it will be, they will just look like a normal duet.
So we're about to see the first of the teams here representing Japan. Atsushi Abe, the 32-year-old, along with Yumi Adachi. They were fifth in the mixed duet technical final.
This is their interpretation of Dracula, music from The Omen, Moonlight Sonata, and Requiem. And it'll be really interesting to see on each duet how much of the performance is synchronized and how much is more creative. Really unusual for the woman to be lifting the man. Hardest thing about this routine is doing complete swim throughs, says it gets really out of breath. A beautiful interpretation. Still superb flexibility there from Yumi, who retired actually after London 2012 and has come back for this. Showing good flexibility, very slightly out on the timing. Love this theme of Dracula, really playing it to the full. Performance. Watch the timing, get the height a bit higher. Well, a beautiful performance there to start the mixed duet free final. Took up synchronized swimming actually after watching the film Waterboys, was inspired by that.
It was fabulous, wasn't it? It was entertaining, it was energetic, plenty of mood in that.
I love the theme. I thought it worked really, really well. Compared with some of the other male synchronized swimmers, he probably needs, well, this is what his coach said actually, he probably needs to work on his body to get in that gym and sort of really build his strength a bit more. But the choreography was absolutely wonderful.
We saw the male lift the female up, and before that, the female lifting the male, which is something we weren't expecting. There's Dracula.
Wow. Got so much expression. I would have preferred, I think, in the actual hybrids, the things where they're upside down doing the figures, I would have liked to have seen a little bit more of that synchronised. But I would imagine that they're going to do well on the artistic.
Well, they qualified 7th of the 10 here with a score of 84.96. Abe and Adachi. And it's an almost identical score, 84.9. So good performance, good start to this competition, down just a fraction of a point on their earlier swim.
Well done. Good swim. Should be really, really proud. He has really deep gratitude, actually, for the synchronized swimmers from 20 years ago that have paved the way to open doors for men to be included in the World Championships.
Second of our mixed duets, Kochi Akun and Yagnia Demikan. Finished sixth in the mixed duet technical, and they're the ninth qualifiers here with a score of 76.5.
Doing the lifting, her feet were not allowed to be touching the bottom of the pool. That would be a penalty, so she has to just use her own strength. What I like about this is that although they're sort of complementing each other occasionally with some of the movements, a lot of it is synchronized, doing exactly the same movement. This, what an occasion for them. Fantastic to see Turkey competing in this event. Again, watch the execution, watch the straight lines. Good performance, a few little errors, especially on those spin down. But I really like watching them. I thought they did a really, really good job. And because they look like they're enjoying it, I found I was smiling all the way through it as well.
Well, it's new territory for all of these teams, these mixed teams, and they're certainly enjoying the opportunity to perform on the world stage. Atgun and Demirkan representing Turkey.
I love that starting pose. He looked very, very balletic, didn't he? Very athletic as well. 16 kilogram weight difference between the two of them, and she was lifting him, so that's pretty good.
Yep, and here we see exactly how they're doing it.
And there's also 6 centimeters height difference, so they have to really work hard on the height adjustments so that when they're in the vertical, they look like they're the same height.
They were awarded 76.5 in the preliminary round, ninth of the 10 teams. 76.3 this time, just a touch lower. 22.8 for execution, 30.6 artistic impression, and that difficulty score of 22.9.
You can really see how much is taken out of them, can't you, with the breathing?
Canada, Leclerc and Prevost. Eighth in the preliminaries. A score of
82.3. Performance. See how high she gets here. Excellent start, really good flexibility. Ten-year age difference. Leclerc 25, Prevost 35. And they were kept on their toes. They only went through to a final selection in June. Find out they were going to be swimming here. Leclerc on the left there was part of the London 2012 team, but then she retired. And here she is back in the water competing again. I'd like to see him swimming a little bit higher in the water. Some good difficulty in here. Of the aquatic art that we used to see many years ago. I like the way he's complimenting her, but I want to see more of it synchronized. Good. Watch the timing. elbows. Excellent. And a really strong finish there from the duet from Canada. Before I came to these World Championships, I hadn't seen them perform before, and I must say I was impressed, really impressed. Realistically, probably not in with a chance of podium. Finished eighth after the preliminaries. The score of 82.33. Needed to work a little bit higher in the water. And I felt that middle section was just a little bit too much on the artistic side, and they needed to get back to the difficulty as well and the synchronization.
Particularly impressive given the short lead-up time. They weren't confirmed with starters until, last month? June.
But they would have worked on it until then. That was final selection. So that was probably to keep them on their toes.
Possibly. Well, they were the eighth through the preliminaries with 82.3. Leclerc and Prevost of Canada. And a strong man, isn't he?
Really strong, really strong. And I'm sure delighted to be part of this history. I'm getting loads of support from the crowd.
A score of 82.53 here. So they have indeed improved upon their morning swim by 0.3 or 0.2, I should say. So won't quibble about a small improvement though, as long as they keep on the up, and that is the way it's been. Excellent effort. Really looking forward to the Czechs and then the French. From the Czech Republic, the male is Andrei Sobolka and Sabina Holopova. Fourth team to compete here. They came in with a score of 73.7.
Competing in this. Overall, the routine will be considerably easier than some of the routines we're going to see. Movements while he was waiting. the spin. Slightly toppled off it. Really nice performance there from the Czech Republic. Fantastic to see them competing here. They look like they thoroughly enjoyed it.
I'd give them bonus points just for choosing pink. I love the music.
Well, there
give
you go.
Give them an extra 5 points.
You should be on the judges' panel then. I thought they complimented each other well.
Yeah,
it
was
simple.
Nice.
They're not going to get a really high score. We know that. But it was a really nice routine. It reminded me, actually, of how synchro used to be maybe 20 years ago. So not too much difficulty in it. But still really, really good to watch. And you almost sort of were willing them to do well. Well, I was anyway.
I was willing the routine to keep going. More from pink, please. Well, let's see what the judges thought.
Sona Bernadova, the very famous synchronized swimmer from the Czech Republic on the left there.
Remembering that their score earlier was 73.7, not overly high. Well, 71.5. So perhaps they might be just a touch disappointed with that, given their earlier score. But very, very enjoyable.
Yeah, that was disappointing to see that they had gone backwards on the score, but I don't think it's really going to make that much difference to their overall placing. They were placed 10th in the preliminaries, and I think they're going to be 10th here as well, I would imagine.
Yeah. Okay, so that was the Czech Republic. How about the next team? That's right, the team from France. And look at the familiar face there. Virginie Dejoux, the 36-year-old, the solo free champion from the World Championships in 2007. And swimming with her, the 37-year-old Benoît Bouffi, who retired in 1998. But after 17 years, he's back and competing at the World Championships. The first time for men. Oh. Isn't that magnificent?
Oh, amazing. Swimming to Roxanne, the tango. Really good height, slightly out of the synchronization. Fabulous to watch them swim together. When he was asked to do the mixed duet, he said absolutely he had to. As far as he's concerned, Virginie Dejoux is the best swimmer to come out of France. Fabulous. Benoît is currently in La Rive in Las Vegas, so a real showman that's really coming across here. Brilliant. Certainly swimming here in the hope of getting a medal. Third after the preliminaries, but it's all about the score today. Really good height and extension. Love that. Looks so good together. Error Virginie, expressive as always. One of the only swimmers not to wear a nose clip. Both look incredibly fit athletes. Virginie, 36, Benoit, 37 years of age. And an inspiration to many, I'm sure, who are watching. Oh, watch the timing. That's a real shame. And right at the end as well, but amazing performance there.
Wasn't that special? The legends from France, Virginie Dedieu and Benoit Bouffi. And will that be enough for a medal?
Wow, they're only 0.8 behind second in the preliminaries. It's going to be really, really close. I did think they made a couple of errors, so, you know, it depends how the others swim, but getting so much support here. And wasn't this incredible? I've never seen a starting position like this. Beautiful. And that wasn't the error, the timing, but look at the height. That, you know, well, that will really help with the difficulty score, but the execution will be down a little bit on that synchronization. Really good extension from both of them.
We noticed a couple of timing problems throughout, and just a little bit of inconsistency despite their ages competing together. And for Benoit, at this style of competition, as distinct from what he does in Las Vegas, still a learning curve.
Oh, very much so, and it's something very different. You know, in Las Vegas, it's all about wiring the crowds, and it's not about the difficulty so much. To actually compete, he will be quite nervous about, he won't want to let his duet partner down, not when it's Virginie Dedieu, a legend.
In the prelims, it was 88.533, and that's what they've done here as well. No change. Dedieu and Bouffi from France, they take over the number one position after five duets have swum the final.
Now they just have to wait and see. They've done incredibly well, considering one lives in France and the other one lives in Las Vegas.
Yeah. Synchronise your time, synchronise your training, synchronise everything. The diary. Team number six now, representing Ukraine. Katerina Resnik and Anton Timofeyev. Timofeyev was fourth in the mixed duet technical with Alex Sabata.
Immediately getting ready for the first lift. It's good, slightly fell forward on it. Watch the timing, come on. Good, got it back together again, excellent. Really putting some difficult moves in here. Good travel around the pool. Swimming to music alone in the dark. Good original choreography there. Thank you. like the fact that a lot of this routine is synchronized. And that might sound like a strange thing to say, but sometimes in these mixed duets, the man just seems to be complimenting the woman too much. Whereas this is technically pretty strong.
Ukraine, Reznik and Timofeyev. Of course, the Ukraine would be feeling pretty good at the moment, having earlier this evening claiming a bronze medal in the duet free. It was through Manasova and Voloshina, and this was a good performance by the team that qualified sixth. It was 85.5 on that occasion. As we have a look underwater, and all the work goes in, and the first of those lifts.
Yeah, I felt that the second two-thirds of the routine was a lot stronger than the first length, which is a real shame because you want to get in there and really create a fantastic, good impression to start with. And there were just a few synchronization errors on that first length. And, you know, I bet they practiced this loads and loads of times and they probably would never do that again. But they made up for it on the second half of the routine. Certainly showed a lot of expression and difficulty in the performance.
So this is team number six out of the 10 finalists as they await their score now.
Score execution.
And it comes up as 85.13, so they've dropped 0.4 on their earlier swim. We're finding that quite a bit with the finals. The scores are moving around a little from their earlier swims and often on the low side.
Yeah, you would hope that the scores would go up because you always get an extra little bit in the finals. But they did make some errors, so I'm not surprised.
Out there in the call room. Bill May, I think you saw Giorgio upside down a moment ago. And now we have one of the big names of the sport for so many years, Gemma Mengual of Spain. Pau Ribes, her partner. Meanwhile, who competed at the Olympic Games in Sydney and Athens and Beijing. She retired in 2012. And now she is back in action here in this mixed duet technical free final.
Swimming to one of my favorite pieces of music. Bring me back to life, effervescence. Age difference here. Power is only 20 years of age. Gemma now 38. Watch the timing. Didn't have enough time to prepare for a technical duet and came here with not really much expectation of a medal, but just wanted to go in and give a really fantastic performance. Brilliant. Thank you. great. The crowd loved that. Energy in this performance. Just watch the timing. Love the choreography. Brilliant, fantastic. Manguel has won nearly 40 major medals in her career, and amazing to see her back competing here again. Superb performance.
Well, wonderful to see a champion back in the pool. Gemma Miguel of Spain, along with her young partner there, Paul Ribes, team number 7 in this mixed duet free final.
I bet they've had so much fun as well doing this choreography, getting it together. And they were so excited to be able to come here and compete. Gemma, a mum now, she's opened a restaurant just outside Barcelona, so her life has moved on since she used to compete. But she's still so supportive of the Spanish team, helping whenever she can, doing lots of coaching. But what an age difference. 18 years age difference between these two. And all credit to Pau Ribes for his approach to the whole thing. Brilliant.
Well, they had the fifth highest score in the preliminary round, 86.9. Interesting to see what the judges have come up with after that routine. Thank you, Gemma. Not sure if that was for you or yourself, Andrea.
Probably me.
Possibly. But isn't it fantastic in this competition to see names like Deju and Bingwile back in action? Just to name a couple. Waiting on the score here. 86.8. Very, very similar to their preliminary score of 86.9. They lie second at the moment. It's the French team in front. He and Deji, followed by Mingwal and Ribe. So we have three duets still to swim. The United States, Italy and Russia. Wouldn't surprise at all if two of those are in the medals, the United States and Russia. Speaking of the USA, here come the Americans now. Justina Lynn Underwood and Bill May.
Bill May is. Currently performs in O in Cirque du Soleil. It's such a dream to compete at World Championships. Swimming to the Firebird, Revenge and Soul Stealer, the Carnival of Lost Souls. Tremendous height on that assisted lift. fantastic. Really good synchronization. Back in 1998, as long ago as that, where they took silver at the Goodwill Games. They've been working really hard together since November with the sole intention of winning the gold here in Russia. Really good difficulty. The most famous male synchronized swimmer and an idol to many of the other competitors here. One of the oldest duets, Bill May, 36, Christina Lum Underwood, 38 years of age. Get on the shoulders out of the water. And these hybrids really well synchronized. Highlights all paying off. Really, really good height.
This American pair who know each other so well, having competed together over so many years, Bill May and Christina Lum Underwood. Bill May already with a gold medal in the mixed duet technical with Christina Jones. Was that enough for another gold here?
I thought it was a superb performance. The coach, Chris Carver, looked delighted as well. I mean, they have worked tirelessly for 20 years to try and get synchro included, and it really would be the fairy tale, wouldn't it, at the end of the story, if they were to take the gold. Somehow you want the books to be written like that. You want Bill May to be part of history in the free duet as well. And I thought their performance was superb.
Plenty of experience between that pair, 38-year-old Christina, 36-year-old Bill. Christina competed in the World Championships in Perth back in 1998, and she was a member of the US team that took the silver medal then. And then she went on 2 years later and competed at the Olympic Games in Sydney, the team finishing fifth.
And amazingly, has got two children, only had a daughter in January.
So the score there, 91.4, 667, they take over the lead. That is a big improvement, almost a full point on their preliminary swim. Well done, Bill May. And Christina Lum Underwood. Well, that really has given the rest of the competition something to think about.
It was a fantastic swim, absolutely fantastic. Yes, they've got to wait, but they can breathe a bit of a sigh of relief that they know they went in there and did their very, very best. Chris Carver on the right there, just... oh. She's done so much to help them.
Well, that's a fabulous performance and a great score for the Americans. And now two duets still to swim here. Italy and Russia. United States in the gold medal position. France down in the silver medal position as it stands. And Spain at third. For Italy, Giorgio Minassini. also Maria Perapatu. Giorgio teamed with Manila Flamini in taking the bronze medal in the mixed duet technical event.
Difficulty they're getting into some of these hybrids, and they're very quick into the highlights as well, and that's how it should be. It should be a real surprise to the judges when they try something like that.
Effort by the Italians there, Minicini and Perapatu. Wonderful effort.
Love the reaction from their coach, Giorgio Brando. She competed back in 1998 in the World Championships. Many, many of these coaches stay on in the sport after they've maybe retired or maybe have a few years off and then come back to it, which is great to see. I was really impressed with this duet. Look at the height she got there. Remember, not allowed to touch the bottom of the pool. Lovely shots of the sculling action. They had really good speed in some of these movements.
They're only about half a point behind France in the preliminary round with 87.9. And it's going to be very interesting to see what the judges have come up with here, because this was an excellent performance. The score for France here, 88.5, and the Americans lead at 91.4. What have they decided on for Italy? 89.3, they're short of a medal. The Italians can do no worse than bronze. Fabulous effort.
It was an amazing performance there, it really was. I mean, the Italians are always expressive, but look at the joy. Roberto Farinelli, Joanna Berlando, they can't believe that their duet has got a medal.
At the moment, they're holding down the silver position. It's the United States in the gold medal position, and Italy silver, France the bronze, but the Russians the only team still to swim. The question is, what colour will it be for the USA and Italy, and can France hold on? The Russians expected the medal here, one of the big teams. The crowd greets Aleksandr Maltsev, Darina Valitova from Russia, the last team in this mixed duet free final. They came in with the second highest score in the preliminary round, the silver medalists from the mixed duet tech.
Their interpretation of Swan Lake. After this, I think there'll be an awful lot more. Astounding performance so far. Brilliant. Very slightly fell off the spin there. So much power. And really showing the core strength there, keeping that vertical line. Both really good extension in their feet. Disappointed with their silver medal in the technical duet. They're trying to go one better here, and this is an amazing performance.
Perhaps it's gold this time as the Americans watch on.
Wow. It was a completely different style than the Americans, wasn't it? But I like the balletic. I thought it was absolutely beautiful, a lot of the movements. I did feel that they made a couple of little errors towards the end, and the judges will have spotted that. But, oh, I think it's going to be really close.
The crowd believes that they've just seen the gold medalists, but then again, they could be a little biased. At the moment, a score of 91.46 leads for the USA. The Russians coming in earlier with a score of 89.36. What have the Russians done in terms of the crowd, in terms of the judges, more to the point? Let's wait on the score. It's gone to Russia. Valitova and Maltsev have ticked out the Americans and claimed the gold medal with the last swim of the night. The Americans claim silver and the Italians the bronze medal. What joy for the Russians.
It was an absolutely amazing performance, though. It really was. There was so much difficulty in that routine. It was beautifully performed. It really was astounding. I loved it. And it was a real contrast, if you like, to the showmanship that you get with the Americans and Bill May and Christina Lum Underwood. And, you know, a little bit disappointing for them, but, you know, they got Christina Jones, Bill May got the gold in the technical. They've got to be happy with that. It was so close, too close to call, but I'm delighted for the Russians. Do you need to ask? I think the pictures tell the story.
The official result, Russia the gold, United States the silver, Italy the bronze, France fourth and Spain fifth. 91.7, the winning score. Then it was the Ukraine, Japan, Canada, Turkey and the Czech Republic in a wonderful competition.